I want to give you a different mindset about life. Be very vigilant not to be against the minorities, because God is interested in the minorities. God uses the foolish things to confound the wise. For God has made the wisdom of this world to come to nothing. I'm going to baffle you today. The question is, why did I hear it? Why did it come to my knowledge? Why did God permit me to hear it? When I heard what happened to a brother in his business, how the fire got him, his house, what is my reaction? Why did God permit me to hear it? So if I say, wicked man, you will die, you who heard me said it should not be happy. That's what God is saying here. For you knowing your own role is played. He said, but his blood will I require at your hand. When a righteous man doeth turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him. Who is the one doing it? When a brother falls out, don't be happy to replace. Don't trickishly put a stumbling block. What do you play with the information you get? Now, Paul said, don't put an occasion of stumbling. Don't even put an occasion. That means anything that will cause a stumbling block to your brother. He said, to one, a stumbling block. To another, it's foolishness. And to another, it is the power of God. And it's also the wisdom of Jesus Christ. The wisdom of God. So, the way you relate with the Bible, it will be how it will work for you. The final result, now get this, the final output of one may not be your output. Will be surprised, like, and Abati will tell you, yes, why you tell me, hey, Mama, I wish I don't be kind here. If you understand truly, that's what I told my pastors, if you know counseling will disturb you, forward it to me. You better don't counsel, because it destroys a man easily. When you give a man wrong directives, God strikes you. What do you play with the information you get? Now, Paul said, don't put an occasion of stumbling. Don't even put an occasion. That means anything that will cause a stumbling block to your brother. It mostly happens to people of the same field of work. A lawyer has a friend who's a lawyer. He wants to set the lawyer up. A singer has a friend who's a singer. Who wants to set the singer up? An instrumentalist who has a friend, or I call it a friend, or who knows someone who is an instrumentalist, who want to set him up in one way or the other, and God says, I will require it on your head. Because the setting up may work. But don't think that when you set somebody up, God says, okay, it will not work. He said it will work. Some will work, and the person will even die for the setup. Mostly the people are weak spiritually. They will die for the setup. But you will live to suffer the person's suffering and your own. Cain physically killed Abel, and God required the blood in Cain's hand. But now we're talking of people who kill others spiritually. The Bible says a time will come that men will kill you thinking they do it God's service. Men will kill you thinking they do it God's service. They shall put you out of a synagogue. Yea, the time cometh that whosoever is killing you, whosoever is killing you, think that he doeth God's service. Listen, when you live let me just assume to call names. God permit me. If you leave Catholic Church, or you leave Presbyterian Church, or you leave Arise and Shine, or you leave Do Me or Do You, leave alone. If you find a place, worship there. But when you go back and tell somebody that leave this place because of this, this, and this, you know that you are doing God's service. Aye. You know that you're what? You are doing God's service. The best way to remove my man from a wrong church is to preach him the Bible. He will see the difference. Men will kill you thinking they are helping you. I want to advise you. That's what I'll tell you. Let me advise you. This is a decision I've made. Listen. Follow this my decision. Let's start this business. It sells. It sells. Who will protect the person on the road? Huh? God is looking at you because God has assigned that man to do the work of this. And you remove the man, this is where his protection is. When you are outside your call, you are outside protection. You are vulnerable to destruction. Let me repeat that statement. When you are outside your call, you are vulnerable to destruction. That's what the Bible says, abide in your calling, so that there may be an edge. He asks Adam, where art thou? Because you are outside where I placed you. So it's possible to be outside and be begging God to help you. It's possible to be outside and be begging what? Be begging God to help you. Whereas you are doing something outside his call. Outside where he called you. There is an appointed time to favor Zion. It means if you are outside Zion, there's no favor. And you'll be praying and begging God, Father, help me for favor. And God says, no, there is no favor. Legata bregoza. There is no favor. Because you are against it. If you want to enjoy flight, find yourself in the plane. You can't be with a bicycle and believe in God for flight. That's witchcraft. Am I communicating? That's what? Witchcraft. Libra gazuzu teleges. Ligo zaprada galades onto soprosh kilahadas. Oh, so it means my life is not my own only. Other people's life who are close to me are my own too. Let me repeat this. You didn't come here just for laying of hands. You came to hear instruction. Hi. Am I communicating? You came to hear instruction. You came to have a new way of living. There are times, get me, there are times God will permit you not to be destroyed, but not after you have gotten knowledge about that kind. The Bible said there remained no more sacrifice. After that, we have received knowledge. So it means there is something that someone will do, and God may not, I use the word may not because it depends on him. God may not count it against the person because the person didn't know. Now the Bible says, for if we sin willfully after that we have received knowledge, what's knowledge? Teachings, preaching. The remaining noble sacrifice for sins. After we have received knowledge. So, what if there are 50 something people here? God is saying that this is what you have been doing. But today, that I'm telling my pastor, my servant, to tell you, after you do it today, no more. It's a warning. After you set up somebody again for the sole purpose of hatred. He said there remained no more sacrifice. Say hallelujah. Why do you see somebody as a threat? Why do you see somebody as though the person is an obstacle? My heart is touched because the whole world is in the political world, right? The politicians are all three quarters are characterized with this system. In fact, that's the definition of politics. A politician mounts the stage during campaign. Our party is the best. Correct. We are going to help this nation or help this city or help the council to achieve this. Correct. There's no problem. You have no faltered. We're going to be roads and schools. We can do this and that. Wonderful. Immediately, you go now. The other man of the other party, they are just deceiving you. You fall into the hands of wrath of God. How many of them end well? Some people don't look at the end of people. Eh? The Bible says a man who builds a house should not calculate the enjoyment. Calculate cost. You see whether you should build or not. So a man wants to enter a job on this thing. Calculate the cost of the life. Will it cost your spirituality? You calculate it first. The person who is into that business, how long does a person attend service? How frequent is evangelism? Before you know that the profit is profitable. Am I communicating? You know, the Bible says, let him that stole steal no more. Rather, let him walk with his hands. Anything? No. He said, the things which are good. Listen. I have given you, that's it. Let him that stole steal no more. Rather, let him labor, walking with his hands. Full stop. No. That which is good. Walk that which is good. Walk that which is good. There are people who are doing businesses that are filled with mafiaism. And as I'm talking like this, they are like calculating. But it is the pay. Two buttons you press, 2 million bucks. Hey. These guys will just meet you on the way and tell you that my name is Emeka. I they come from Niger. Please, I they find Madam Cynthia. You do you know her? You said no. Why I they find her? Because I don't know where to sleep. I came with phones and money. I don't know who can help me where I will sleep, and then I can help you. I beg. Are they in trouble? And you too. Who doesn't work hard in life? If you are even working hard, you have your car. Yes, you not even meet them. Because you are on foot, you meet them on foot. Most people with food have too much trouble. Those with cars have only accident, one trouble. It's only accident. The second trouble, only police, that's all. Barefoot. You meet mad men on the way. I was walking towards Munya last year, around December. And there was a tall madman. This man is huge. The master of his church, patapa, man, I skipped. What am I doing on foot? Am I communicating? So stop walking on foot. And as you have heard this message now about walking on foot, God said, now after this knowledge of stop walking on foot has come, buy a car. Now, any prayer that follows with amen is still in belief. Yes. Okay. Now let's get back to business. Amen. Are you enjoying what I'm saying, Tony? Let him walk with his hands the things which are good. These guys will press computer and somebody show somebody a puppy that is not existing. And the man say, how much? He said, I have them 10. The man sends money. You close the account. 2.2 million. You go open another account. You hit. Bam! Move before. You chop. Ere for Mukutu and Dame from those. You quote wonderful scriptures.
You need to see your verses. Ere from Buku to chapter 1. No make ere. It's wonderful how people live their life. Praise the Lord. People live their life funnily. Everything around them determines their life. They just want to see you ride a good car and ask you, what do you do? That's all. They are into it. Wait, they might tell you, want, now let's come in, don't make you define so. And when I get computer, it waits for us. That's all. He starts. The Bible said the things which are good. There are some other farmers. Let me say this with farmers. He plants maize. His neighbor plants maize. There's a common boundary, and he knows the boundary. Harvest, he came first. There are farmers here. Psychological crooks. He comes for harvest. Neighbor is not. He harvests. Pretend as if he doesn't know. He enters the other neighbor. Harvest. Instead of 2 bags, he has 3 bags. And he says, 3 bags enough money. The things which are good. That he may have to give. Isn't it wonderful that God wants you to do something that is profitable? Something that is good. Praise the Lord. Something that is good. Now we're talking about stumbling block but stepping stone. Who remember the story of Noah? You remember the story of Noah? I want to recite you something there, though you may not find it word for word in the scriptures. When Noah warned the people about the voice of God, they didn't believe. True? They never believed. And later, the 8 persons entered with him, and the animals entered after their kind, pair. And God sent flood. There were houses in the city. And maybe there were houses taller than the Ark of Noah. And there were other boats in the city used for fishing. There were other boats in the city used for fishing. There were houses. There were floating objects that could float and you hold it and be safe. But when the water came, because the water came for another purpose, when judgment comes, you know, when I was in Kumba, I heard of a story where a woman was carrying a child on her back. And thunder struck. I don't know what she did. But the strong thunder came, took the child and placed on the ground. Not that the child fell. Have you heard such stories? It happened at the park. I was hawking then. We came and saw the woman black and the child was sitting on the ground. The judgment was not for everybody. So, with the Ark of Noah, when the water fell heavy for 40 days and night, the Bible says everywhere was floated. Water was everywhere, sorry. And everyone on earth died. Surprisingly, the water was higher than the Ark of Noah. It could have penetrated the windows or maybe the roof. But instead, the water quietly lifted up the ark and killed the other people. The water was a stumbling block to the people of the world, but the same water was a stepping stone. Am I communicating? The same water was a stepping stone. It depends how you see things. It depends how you see things. Which eye do you use to see? Which ear do you use to hear? When Jesus appeared to Peter, in a vision in Acts chapter 10. He said, Peter, rise up, kill and eat. Peter said, Master, this is Peter. He said, I know. I don't eat this kind of things you are showing. Because as tradition is concerned, that was a stumbling block. All the animals were uneatable according to the tribe. Some of you don't eat snails. But to those in Memphis, it's a stepping stone. Praise the Lord Jesus. Stumbling block, birds, stepping stone. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 23. But we preach Christ crucified. So, the Christ we preach for the Jews is a stumbling block. And Jesus was a Jew. And to the people of the Greek, it's foolishness. The same Christ we preach. Are you seeing how it is seen differently? We preach one Christ. Somebody came and saw it as a stumbling block. Another person saw the same Christ as foolishness. And that's what is happening in the world today. Some people tell you that if you remain in church, you won't get married though. If you remain in church, you will enjoy life. You remain in church, church will chop your money. An off-license will give you money. Nightclubs add your money. Abi? No. If you remain in church, this will happen to you. You will see your friends excelling, and your own is to preach. Woe betide me the day I stop preaching the gospel. Even if you take all my finance, I will still walk the street and tell somebody, Jesus is Lord. I said, Jesus. Because I never loved Jesus when I was rich. I loved him before this money came or before this fame. So it means Jesus, not at any state. At any state, I will love him. And to other people, Christianity is foolishness. Because if you're a legal luminary in our field of nonchalant catamount, you will not find yourself in the vicinity of prayer wood. You walk with your hands to achieve your nemos and your destiny. Go to the house of God, check how many people have PhD. Instead, you find people who need PhD, prayer, healing, and deliverance. Because to some people, it's foolishness. The scholars. Thank God for the way God is using men of God now. They have jets even more than the rich people. And you know what? People now, get this. This man of God has bought a jet. You hear comments. He's squandering people's money to buy his cars. He has hypnotized his Christians to buy his jet. And there's a medical doctor who has a jet. Of course he's a medical doctor. He's okay. It's his knowledge. Of course it's the pastor's gift. A man's gift maketh room for him and bringeth him before great men. But you find people who are not happy with Christianity will tell you that.
To get a full copy of this message, call us on these numbers, +237 652 848 668, +678 873 666,
or email at transformerstv@yahoo.com.
Apostle Divine Co. Kefor.
Major.